fall apart, and you're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I come, I confess, bowing here, I find my rest. Without you, I fall apart. You're the one that guides my heart. Lord, I need you. Oh, I need you. Every hour I need you. My one defense, my righteousness. Oh, God, how I need you. Where sin runs deep, your grace is more. Where grace is found is where you are. And where you are, Lord, I am free. Holiness is Christ in me. Oh, Lord, I need. Teach my soul to rise to you when temptation comes my way. And when I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. So teach my soul to rise to you when temptation comes my way. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. So teach my soul to rise to you. When temptation comes my way, when I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. When I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. My one defense, my rock. righteousness. Oh God, how I need you. So teach my soul to rise to you when temptation comes my way. And when I cannot stand, I'll fall on you. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. So teach my soul to rise to you when temptation comes my way. And when I cannot stand, I'll fall on you, Jesus. Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Jesus, Jesus, you're my hope and stay. Oh, Jesus, you're my hope and stay. By the weight of everything, when I think I've reached the end, there you are facing me. Facing me. Gently leading me forward, you are, you are. Right here by my side, right here by my side, right here by my side. You're not leaving, you're not going anywhere, you're right by my side. Right by my side, right by my side. Saying I'm right here, child, I'm right here, child. It's not all on you, 'cause you're yoked with me. Taking the weight of the world off, 'cause you're yoked with me. yoked with me, be free. See that it's real, that it's good. Your sweetness, with your glory, with a vision of you, with a vision of you. Been so distracted. I've been overwhelmed by other things. How easily I look away. How easily I get distracted from your gaze. I can be, confused I can be. But God, you know this. You already know this. But God, you know this. You see it before it. That's why you send help. That's why you send help. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit. Here I find true peace. true joy. Here I find true peace. Here I find true joy. Nothing greater than feeling it's effortless to worship you than to sit here at your feet. The start before the beginning of time. With no point of reference, you spoke to the dark and fleshed out the wonder of life. And as you speak, 100 billion galaxies are born in the vapor of your breath, the planets born. If the stars were made to worship, so will I. I can see your heart in everything you've made. Every burning star, a signal fire of grace. If creation sings your praises, so will I. God of your promise, don't speak in vain, no syllable empty or void. For once you have spoken, all nature and science follow the sound of your voice. And as you speak, 100 billion creatures catch your breath, evolving in pursuit of what you said. If it all reveals your nature, so will I. I can see your heart in everything you say. Sky, a canvas of your grace. If creation still obeys you, so will I. So will I. If the stars were made to worship, so will I. If the mountains bow in reverence, so will I. If the oceans roar your greatness, so will I. For if everything exists to lift you high, so will I. If the wind goes where The sum of all our praise is still full shy. Then we'll sing again 100 billion times. Oh, 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 God of salvation. Chase down my heart through all of my failure and pride. And on a hill you created the light of the world, abandoned in darkness to die. And as you speak, disappear. Where you lost your life so I could find it here. If you left the grave behind you so alive, I can see your heart in everything you've done. Every part designed in a work of art called love. If you gladly chose surrender, so will I. I can see your heart 8 billion different ways. Every precious one, a child you died to save. You gave your life to love them, so will I. Like you would again 100 billion times. Like you would again 100 billion times. But what measure could amount to your desire? You're the one who never leaves the one behind. Stars were made to worship, so will I. If the mountains bow in reverence, so will I. If the oceans roar your greatness, so will I. Or if everything exists to lift you high, so will I. If the wind goes where you send it, so will I. If the rocks cry out in silence, so will I. If the sound of all our praises still falls shy, then we'll sing. So will I. If the mountains bow in reverence, so will I. If the oceans roar your greatness, so will I. For if everything exists to lift you high, so will I. If the wind goes where you send, so will I. If the rocks cry out in silence, so will I. If the sound of all our praise still falls shy, then we'll sing. don't speak in vain, no syllable empty or void. For once you have spoken, all nature and science follow the sound of your voice. We're heaven-spun creations, His pride and adoration, treasures woven by His love. His careful hands, they hold us safe within His promise of calling and of destiny. I will sing of all you've done, and I'll remember how far you've carried me from beginning until the end. You are faithful, faithful to the heart that's for me, a never-ending story of love that's always chasing me. His kindness overwhelming and hope for me unending. He's never given up on me, and I will see all you've done, and I'll remember how far you've carried me from beginning until the end. You are faithful, faithful to the end, and I will sing of all you've done. You let me fall, in all of my life your love has been true, and with all of my life I will worship you. There wasn't a day that you weren't by my side, and there wasn't a day that you let me fall, and all of my life your love has been true, and with all of my life I will worship you. There wasn't a day that you weren't by my side, and there wasn't a day that you let So let me never hesitate to testify. Let me never hesitate to testify. To testify. To testify. To testify of your greatness, of your worth. Unfathomably more than I can ask or imagine. How great you are, how great you are. So much more beyond the surface. So much more beyond what I can see. Working all things for our good. Working all things for your glory. The redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord cry out for his glory. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Thank you.
God, we pray our lives would be a testimony of your glory. That our lives would be a song sung to you, rejoicing in everything that you have done. God, we pray that you would direct our testimony, that you would speak loudly through each one of us. The message would be clear. You are sovereign, you are holy, and we praise your name, God. You are worthy. You're worthy of our praise. Amen. We're now going to go into a time of singing and praying through the Word of God. Tonight we'll be reading from Psalm 27. If you have your Bible, please open to Psalm 27 and join us as we sing, pray, and meditate on the Word. Psalm 27, verses 1 through 3. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked advanced against me to devour me, it is my enemies and my foes who will stumble and fall. Though an army besiege me, my heart will not fear. Though war break out against me, even then I will be confident. Lord, you are the only one strong enough that I can look to. You are the only one who knows in the confusion, who is worthy in the hopelessness. You are the stronghold that I run to. God, whether the attacks come from within me or without, you are the one we turn to, the strong tower of protection from every foe. And in the fight, you reveal the truth of every battle, that the enemy is insignificant. The enemy is weak in the light of your strength. The reality is that the battle is yours every single time. While the enemy thrashes around, I am at rest in the refuge of your mighty hand. No one can touch us in the refuge of your mighty hand. You are not afraid, so I will rest. You are not undone, so I will hope. You are not confused, so I will trust. You are not intimidated, so I will stand in confidence. God, teach our hearts to trust in your love. Cast out fear when we meet enemies of every kind. As our foes stumble and fall, we look to see the truth that you are greater, that you are stronger, that any wicked advance cannot come against us to devour. Even in war, when it breaks out, I will be confident in the glory, in the strength, in the might, in the sovereignty of your mighty hand. You are holy, you are sovereign, you are mighty. We run to you. We run to your refuge. We curl up in your mighty hand and rest, because you are God. You are in control. You are worthy and you are strong. Teach us to rest and open our eyes to see the reality of every fight, the reality of every battle. The truth is that you have won, that you have the victory, and we rest. We trust in the knowledge that you are strong. Let's pray.
Shall not fear. My heart shall not fear. is against me. Through signs of calamity all around, my heart shall not fear. But I'll be firm and steadfast, as I'm standing on the one who's unshakable, standing on the one who's untouchable. My heart shall not fear. My heart shall not fear. As I list out my fears one by one, as I list them all out, counter them with your truth. You realign my heart and mind to yours, teaching me again, showing me again that there is indeed no reason to fear. Indeed, no reason to fear. Teaching me again, showing me again so patiently. There is indeed no reason to fear. There is indeed no reason to fear. Peace will testify. My peace will testify. In the storm, in the war, my peace will testify. My peace will testify. In the storm, in the war, my peace will testify.
Make me a testimony.
My peace will testify.
There's no need to fear.
In the midst of it all, my peace will testify.
I will rest in you.
My peace will testify. Oh, there's nothing to prove. Nothing to prove. I have no strength to prove my own, have no strength to prove. It's only this I am confident in, the God I love. Only this I am confident. God, I love.
Psalm 27, verses 4 through 6. One thing I ask from the Lord, this only do I seek, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to gaze on the beauty of the Lord, and to seek him in his temple. For in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set me high upon a rock. Then my head will be exalted above the enemies who surround me. At his sacred tent, I will sacrifice with shouts of joy. I will sing and make music to the Lord. Lord, when I run into your presence, I find rest and purpose. I find hope and peace. You invite me in. You invite me into your presence, and it's far greater than just a safe refuge from my enemies. Here in your house, in your temple, in your refuge, everything becomes clear, and I see the enemy for what it is. Every enemy is minuscule next to you. Every attack falls far short, and I sing far over the heads of every foe. In the midst of confusion and pain, I will shout and rejoice for all that you've done, all that you've promised, and all that you've given. You hide me in the shelter. I will stay in your sacred tent, high upon a rock. Your protection is perfect. I will rejoice. Sacrifice shouts of joy and make music to you because I can see that you are above it all. You lift me up above the heads of my enemies. You lift me up above the confusion. The arrows of the enemy cannot reach me here. I am safe in your shelter. To simply gaze upon your beauty, to seek you all the days of my life. This is the one thing I ask, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life.
Your presence. Oh. Over.
from the redeemed, coming from his children, coming from the redeemed. Oh, 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 oh. So take heart. To the one thing, take heart. Look to the one thing.
Psalm 27, verses 7 through 12. Hear my voice when I call, Lord. Be merciful to me and answer me. My heart says of you, seek his face. Your face, Lord, I will seek. Do not hide your face from me. Do not turn your servant away in anger. You have been my helper. Do not reject me or forsake me, God, my Savior. Though my father and mother forsake me, the Lord will receive me. Teach me your way, Lord. Lead me in a straight path because of my oppressors. Do not turn me over to the desire of my foes, for false witnesses rise up against me, spouting malicious accusations. Lord, I cry out to you. It is my first reflex and my last resort. At every sign of trouble, I run to you. When I can't see you clearly, when I can't see your hand, you instruct my heart. Through the confusion and through the noise of my mind, seek his face. When all others abandon me, rise up with accusations, I lose sight of the one who will never forsake me, never reject me, never send me away in anger. Open my eyes to see you. I'm lost until I seek your face. God, I am safe in your rest. I am loved in your presence. Here it all makes sense and the questions fall away. Teach my heart to run to you, to seek your face. You do not hide. You do not turn me away. You do not reject or forsake. I run to you. You will not walk away. You invite me in deeper. Even as I look at your face, my heart says, seek his face. I will seek you. You will be found. You are so close. I will trust in your everlasting love for me, your desire to be with me. When all others walk the other way, when anyone oppresses or turns their face from me, accusing, God, you are there. I turn to you, your face I seek, and you are there. To you, Jesus,
Just when it's convenient, not just when I'm in trouble, but I cling to you, Jesus. I run to you, Jesus, because of love, because of love. Face, Lord, you don't hide. Your face, Lord, you don't hide from me. Your face, Lord, do not hide. Your face, oh Lord, do not hide from this, you hear me, Lord. I know you hear me, Lord. Surely you hear me, Lord. Every small plea in my heart, the hunger and the thirst, you hear it, you see it.
Psalm 27, verses 13 and 14. I remain confident of this. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord. Be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord. God, you establish me in truth as I rest in your presence, and all is at peace. You don't just give peace for the moment in the midst of my enemies, but you instill my heart with courage and hope. Because you are who you are, I can rise and go with confidence, knowing that I will see your goodness here. When I cannot see it with my eyes, I will trust in the reality of your kingdom established here in the land of the living. I will see you at work. I will trust in your work. I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. This is my cry of confidence. No matter what rises against me, no matter what season I stand in the middle of, I will see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. It's not only later, it's also now. I remain confident in you. Establish your kingdom. Let us see it in the land of the living. With hope and gladness to see your sovereignty, your holiness, your worthiness here in the land of the living. So I will wait for the Lord. I will be strong and take heart and wait for the Lord.
Yeah, I know there's more. see your goodness. I believe I shall see your goodness.
You are good.
In greater measures, in increasing measures. I believe I shall see it. I believe I shall see it. Just you wait, more await, just you wait, more await, just you wait and see that more await. Just you wait and see, and more await. Just you wait. 'Cause he has been waiting to pour out his mercy and grace. He has been waiting and longing to pour out more. He has been waiting and longing to pour out grace. He has been waiting and longing to pour out more, more awaits. Oh, just you wait. Of the Lord in the land of the living. See the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living.
God, I thank you that you are a strong tower, a refuge to run to. You invite us in closer and deeper into your presence than we've ever been before. And as our enemies drive us further in to you, we thank you. We thank you that there is always more. We have confidence in your love. We have confidence in your worthiness. Take us in deeper. open our eyes to see your goodness. We trust in you. We come to you and rest. Yeah, God, let us find our strength in your rest. Thank you, Jesus. Now we'll be going into a time of intercession through prayer topics. Tonight we'll be praying for North Korea, specifically for the most vulnerable men, women, and children in North Korea. Please come into agreement with me as I pray along with the prayer points on the screen, and then raise intercession with your own voice as the Spirit leads you to pray through each topic. Lord, you see the ones who feel tossed aside, who feel used up and weary. You know the tears they've cried. You know the struggles their families have to provide for them. God, you see the elderly men and women of North Korea. So many of them have been waiting to reunite for a day with family members across the border, only to miss out each time as the agreements are broken or their name isn't picked. God, I pray that these would find hope in you, that they would find purpose, and that they would find comfort. God, you see their heartache. Wipe the tears from their eyes and lift their eyes to your face. We pray for those who do not have a home, those whose families cannot or will not care for them. God, we pray that you would supply their needs, that you would provide each need. Pray for those living with their children and their families, that they would know the comfort and support of their loved ones rather than the stress and worry of being a burden to them. God, we break off the lie that the elderly are a burden. We break off the lie that they are used up, that they have no value. We declare the practice of families openly inviting the spirit of self-destruction with signs on the doors of their elderly family members completely eliminated. Let the eyes of the blind be opened to the grievousness of pressuring their loved ones into suicide. We declare the desperation of families to drive them further into the truth of your salvation. Let salvation sweep through entire households and turn the hearts of the children to their parents. Let them know the salvation and provision that you can provide. Let them no longer look to the government or look to anything else, looking to money to come through. God, we pray that you would sweep through these households with trust, with faith, with the truth that you are there to hold the heads of those who are tired and those who are weary. God, we pray that you would open your arms, that elderly men and women would find their rest and find their comfort in you and you alone. Let's pray. Thank you. Lord, we pray for those left orphaned in North Korea. As children lose their parents through imprisonment, starvation, sickness, accident, or abandonment, we declare that these little ones are yours and they are loved. You are the father to the fatherless. You are the mighty defender of the weak. Father, pluck these little ones from the depths and give them crowns as your heirs. We trust in your provision. Father, meet all their needs. We declare that those who feel worthless will find their worth in your lineage, even when they cannot depend on their earthly one. In a land where family lines mean everything, God, we pray that they would find their rest and find their salvation in you and you alone. Give them rest for their souls and peace that doesn't make any sense as they find their salvation in Christ alone. God, we pray that you would sweep through the orphans in North Korea, that they would know the truth, that they would find it written on their hearts, the truth that what they see is not everything, that they have not been thrown away, that they have not been tossed aside. God, we pray that this generation, the orphans of this generation, would rise up and take their place in leadership and change. That those who have nothing left to lose would find that they have everything to gain just following in your steps, allowing you to guide their lives. Let them find their security and salvation in you. Let's pray. Lord, you are in the business of setting captives free. We thank you for the release of the American prisoners last week from North Korea. We pray fresh grace for those advocating on behalf of the South Korean prisoners, as well as many others from other nations who have been imprisoned by this regime. God, for the thousands and thousands of North Koreans facing long sentences in all manners of prisons and camps throughout North Korea, God, we pray that you would work miracles in their midst. Sweep through the camps with the power of your Spirit, God. Bring hope and rest and safety. Supply all their needs through the riches of your glory. Set their spirits free through salvation. As your word opens the doors through inmates and guards alike. As the people are thrown aside into these camps, into these prisons, left and forgotten, let them know that you have never forgotten them, that you have not forsaken them. We prophesy the abandonment of work camps, the abandonment of prison camps, the abandonment of re-education camps, the abandonment of every form of torture. Let it be a testimony to all of your justice and sovereignty over every king and every nation. Release the captives and set their hearts free through salvation. Let's pray. God, we thank you that you are the one who fights for the weak, and you will be victorious. God, we claim that victory is yours for those who are enslaved in lies. God, we pray for each of these North Korean men and women, the elderly men and women of North Korea, the orphans of North Korea, those who are imprisoned in North Korea. Let them find shelter in the shadow of your wings. Let them run to your mighty tower for refuge. Let them find strength in their weakness as you pour strength out on them. Let them know grace like they've never known before. God, bring justice. Bring mercy. Bring peace and bring rest. We know the truth that these are your beloved creation. They have not been tossed aside and they have not been forgotten. We pray that tonight they would know their value and they would know rest and safety in you. You are sovereign above all, and we thank you, God. Amen.